Civil society representatives, former prisoners of conscience and media workers held a roundtable in the IRFS Press Center to discuss the pre-trial detention of young opposition activist and Musavat Party member Nigar Yaqublu. Economic Research Center head Kubat Libadoglu informed the participants about the arrest of Yaqublu in connection with a road accident that happened on August 25th, taking the life of another Musavat Party member Aydın Ecelov, who also was on board. On September 10th, Abşeron Regional Court sentenced Yaqublu to pre-trial detention. Ibadoglu expressed his concern over this decision, saying that it may set an incredibly bad precedent for similar cases. Nigar's father Tofiq Yaqublu said that her daughter never avoided investigation, as investigator Rafiq Hasanov claims. According to the father, Nigar was in the hospital from August 25th until September 4th. She had been to the police office on September 4th after being summoned by the investigator. Yaqublu visited the police office again on September 6th but couldn't provide an account of the accident as the investigator was not in the office. On September 9th, she went to the police station for the third time, after which the case was submitted to the court. The court did not initially rule for pre-trial detention. The decision to detain Yaqublu was produced on September 10th. "We think the investigation was non-objective," said the father. Lawyer Adil Ismail suspects that Nigar's arrest is politically motivated. "If the Court of Appeals does not change the decision, my suspicions will prove to be right," said the lawyer. Civil society representatives decided to appeal to the president and law enforcement agencies for the release or bail of Yaqublu.